Let's hop in, shall we? How to prepare for your first stream. This can seem daunting, and it actually, some people, when they're doing their first stream, just pop right on and go for it. I recommend doing some research beforehand. This will give you a pretty good idea of the things that you need to look into before you hop onto your first stream, and this will help your first stream be more successful right from the start. First, social media-wise, if you don't have a Twitter, get a Twitter. It's the most sex worker-friendly social media. This can be where your fans can follow you when you're not online. Don't use it as a personal Twitter, but you can have some kind of playful interaction with some of your viewers offline. This is also where you will be able to post when you are getting online and provide a link so it's really easy to get to your room once you are online. Things you need to look into are the apps and bots. These will help you notify your viewers on tip menus, social media, rules you have, different promotions you have going on, things like that. These are going to be able to provide notices through your chat while people are typing and chatting, notices to let them know things that you offer. There are also bots for different tip goals, different games you can play. It gets really extensive. Down to the basics, it can be as simple as just a rotating notifier so that people can see your social media. So I will put a few of my favorite bots that I've used in the past down in the description below so that you guys can use some of those to get started, and then just keep exploring from there to see which ones work best for you. I've talked about this in a couple other videos. When you're streaming, consistency is key. This means consistency with what time of day you're getting online and what days of the week. If you can get online one day a week, make sure it's the same day every single week. If you can get on twice a day, make sure that they are the same time frames every single day. So think about this before you get online for the first time. That first stream is going to reflect the rest of them and be in line with the schedule that you're going to set in the future. Look into downloading an OBS or similar software. I'm using one right now that helps me put like this up here, the DMCA notice right here. Avoid putting anything in this corner because it gets blocked by the Chatterbait logo. But in this top corner, I recommend putting a text box that has your OnlyFans link in it so that people can type that in easily. Or if you have any specials going on, things like that, just put them up there. Even if they don't look through the chat and all of your notices that you have going, if they see your screen, they'll see it there. This is my cam room. Consider before you're getting online ready to go stream where you're going to be streaming from. But you want to make sure the space is well lit and the camera angle is flattering and set. You don't want to have to keep fiddling with this all the time. I don't know why I just touched it because now I have to make sure it's back. Okay. When you're choosing a camera angle, make sure you feel like you look good. If you don't feel like you look good in the camera, you're not going to feel confident when you're streaming because you're going to be looking at yourself and seeing where you are in the view of the camera. So you want to make sure you feel good about how you look. If you're going to be playing any music, make sure you get that set up ahead of time, along with all the other little details like if you need any props, if you're going to need a bottle of water. Just make sure that you do everything beforehand, before you click stream, so that everything's ready to go and near you. If you need a towel, stuff like that. As soon as you have to get off screen, you're going to lose their attention and they're probably going to leave. And you don't want to encourage that at all, so you want to make sure you have everything here next to you when you start streaming. I will put a list right here of some of the things that I think you should have near you before you click stream so that you have a little baseline of what to use to get started. These are things that I didn't necessarily know, and I noticed that if I have to go get them, I will lose engagement a little bit and have to kind of work my way back up just a little bit. I've gotten used to being able to warn them, like, I'm going to be back in 10 seconds or less, don't you go anywhere, like a commercial break, and then going and getting the stuff and coming back, and usually most people are there, but this does take time to make sure that they know you are coming back quickly. I've seen models say, I'll be right back, I'm going real quick, and then 20 minutes later they're still not back, and everyone gets really frustrated, and they're not going to want to watch you anymore because they don't know if you're going to leave for 20 minutes. So make sure that if you do have to leave the camera screen, you come back quickly. When it is actually time to stream, here are a few things that you need to do right before you get online, literally within 5 minutes before clicking that stream button. One, start all those bots you set up. Make sure that you have them set up beforehand, but you'll have to restart them every time you get online. Two, make sure you tweet out that you are getting online with a link and a picture. You want to say, I'm online. You want to have a link to your site, specifically to your room, and then a picture of what you look like. This will help people stop on that post because of the picture. The link makes it really easy for them to find you, and then it also tells them why you're posting the link. If you need to connect your Love Ents toy or any other toys like that, make sure you do that before you get online, and you're not just sitting there on your phone trying to connect your Love Ents toy to the computer for the first 20 minutes of your stream. Last thing to make sure you do before you get online is set your subject line and put your hashtags in your subject. There are 5 hashtags allowed. If you're new, make sure one of them is hashtag new. There's actually a list on their website on Chatterbait. There's a tab called tags where you can go search through all the ones that are available. With all of these things that I've mentioned, the general idea is you want to make sure that you are actually thinking about the details before you get online. If you're trying to think these things through as you're getting online or while you're already streaming, it's going to feel really jumbled. You're not going to be able to think as fast because you're also going to be trying to pay attention to the chat room itself. So try to think about all of these quality details before you get online. A lot of these do apply for every time you get online, so these are really good to learn now. If I need to go into more detail about anything specifically, let me know in the comments. Don't forget to subscribe and also follow me on Twitter. This is the handle on Twitter as well, so it's really easy to find, and I hope to talk to you soon. Have a good rest of your day. What was that wave? No, I'm not gonna ever do that again. Okay.